It is a couple of weeks before a brand new college hockey season will kick into high gear. But it is a time of the year when the forecasters go to work and offer forth their prognostications. And so it is that many are speaking well of the U.S. Little Hockey Riverhawks. College Hockey News puts the Riverhawks ninth in the country. And the Sporting News goes even further, ranking the Riverhawks fourth in the country and tops among Hockey East teams. The Hockey Club, meanwhile, goes through its work on and off the ice, the preparation for a new season. And what does the coach think of all of this? We sat down with UMass Lowell Hockey head coach Blaze McDonald and asked.
A lot of people have a lot of expectations. Do you, does this team, does this program worry about others' expectations or predictions?
That's not our control. Like, that's, we have a really bad focus if we're worrying about other people. So, I mean, it's impossible for any outside source to create higher expectations than we create internally. As a coach, I'm proud that other people look at our players and give them respect to rank the team highly, and we play as a coordinated team. That's a credit to the player. So it's nice to see them get that sort of recognition. And, you know, we've had some really good hockey programs here at Lowell over the years. You know, Bruce Crowder had two teams make the NCAA tournament, and, you know, hopefully it's a sense of excitement for alumni in the community to see that, hey, going into the season, there's a lot of people think this hockey team's pretty good, has a chance to be pretty special. But we're just focused on what we need to do, and you know, we've had enough experiences. Typically, you're a sum of your experience, and the experiences we've had are pretty good, and that's going to give us some confidence moving forward this season.
We talk about others' expectations. What are your expectations for this team, for this program?
My expectations are really to just continue on the road that we were on last year. You know, we evolved quite well as the season went on. You know, we suffered through a little bit of the injury bug like we have every single year, and that's problematic and troublesome for us. You know, it's part of the game, but it seems every year we get our fair share of injuries. So my expectations are really to pick up where we left off. And the guys have done a great job of controlling the controllables. You know, their fitness level is terrific. I think their outlook is really, really good. Work habits, that's critical. Like, I think for us, we understand the margin of victory for us and the margin of error. My expectations are, like, we need to manage those components of our preparation, of our game management, and then how we respond to, you know, wins and losses.
Other people often define expectations by getting to the Garden, playing for a Hockey East championship, getting to the NCAA tournament, various benchmarks that are summed up by standings or by record or by how far in the postseason. When you talk about expectations, you talk more about intensity of work and those sorts of things. Are we approaching things the wrong way if we talk about expectations as far as tournaments and that sort of thing?
We, as in the media and fans?
Yeah.
No, that's your job. For us, it's clearly the journey is what we're all about. And we want to get ourselves in position to win championships. So, you know, first and foremost, we need to beat St. Lawrence to give ourselves a chance to win a championship in the icebreaker. Then we need to play well through the regular season. We get to the Dartmouth tournament, be in a position to play for a championship, be in a position to get the best seeding, for the playoffs in Hockey East. Then do your best to get to the Boston Garden. You get there, now you get a chance to win another championship. So kind of that's, if we get ourselves in those positions, then we just play. You know, it's, do we want to win a national championship? Of course you do. Like, you don't go into the season thinking, hey, let's work for third place, guys. It's just not the way we are. We have a talented group of young men, a focused group, a committed group, and we think we could beat any team in the country. You know, the difference between, like, the very best teams in the country and kind of the middle of the pack, It's not a great difference. As a matter of fact, I had a great conversation with John Morris, our all-time leading scorer in Hockey East history, yesterday. And he was talking about, and he has a really good eye for the game and makes great observations, that, like, in his day when he played for Billy Riley, they went to the NCAA tournament. And they made the tournament, but he's like, you know, we had no chance of beating Minnesota. They were just way better than we were, much more talented. Whereas, like, he was saying, he saw our team last year. He's like, you know, you could beat BU. the national champs, and you could beat Miami, and you could have beaten Vermont, and you did. So now it's like, okay, you make the NCAA tournament, but now you get a realistic chance at winning it because there's so much parity in the game today. I feel strongly that our team mirrors that, that we, you know, when we get in the tournament, we, you know, we can win it as much as anybody.
You mentioned the phrase the journey, and we've talked about it often in the past. I don't know if we've ever defined the journey, the beginning and end points of the journey, but in your mind, in that journey that you and this program are on, this team is on, where in that journey are we as we enter or prepare to enter a new season?
Well, I think clearly we've set ourselves up with a sum of experiences from last year where we played in front of big crowds, played for a Hockey East championship, played for an opportunity to go to the NCAA tournament, didn't win. Very frustrated, but yet played very honorably. You know, played, we were worthy of perhaps winning that game. So that sum of experience tells us, okay, going into this part of the journey, now let's continue on. Like we often tell our teams, and I think a lot of coaches do this, you know, at the end of practice, and you had a really good practice, you want to start tomorrow's practice where you ended today's. You don't want to take any steps backwards, so you're continually building. And that's, you know, that's kind of the outlook that we have for the season. And like I said, we have quality depth in all positions, and it's going to be competitive. And, you know, I think we have good structure and really coachable young men. So we're in a good place.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks, Mr. Ellis.
And we will note the Riverhawks open the season October 9th against St. Lawrence. That is in Omaha, Nebraska. It is the opening round of the Icebreaker Tournament. The home opener will be a couple of weeks later, October 23rd. Colgate will be in town. Make a note of that.